opportunities presented to four bishop students by the school's Global Issues Network has resulted in two initiatives that promise to uplift the Indovlu project in Monobisi Park. It all started out with the students playing the virtual reality game Urgent Evoke.
Evoke is a virtual reality online game. It was created by the World Bank to teach young people around the world about global issues. The format that it took was that of a graphic novel, and each week new episodes were released about global challenges that will face us in the world ahead, like food security, water shortages, women's rights. Each week, those playing the game had to research around the topic that was revealed in the graphic novel. On the rest of the video are some of the ideas that they did come up with.
Global Issues Network members worked in pairs to find real solutions to global problems. Worldwide, 19,000 students took part. Bishops Grade 10 learners Reid Falconer and Martin Dyer investigated food security in informal settlements, while Emil Nauter and Kishan Chagan researched the causes of fires in densely populated urban areas.
They had to come up with solutions to the problems. They had to imagine what those solutions could be. And in this way, they gained a better understanding of the challenges that will face our world.
Well, this is the original garden site. As you can see, this is where they're growing their vegetable garden. But we've tested the soil, and the soil is not that good, and it could be way better than this.
So the idea was to give the people at the Global Project the opportunity to attend the permaculture courses, which was offered by Soil for Life, which is the NGO in Constantia. We received the funding for this via Evoke, which was an online crash course sponsored by the World Bank. Then we got an opportunity to go on Global Giving.
Which what is the importance of Global Giving in this venture of yours?
Okay, Global Giving is an online marketplace where NGOs worldwide can put their project onto the web, and anybody worldwide can donate money from their computer. So far, our project has raised around about $5,000.
And for the future?
We wanted to expand our idea a bit bigger and try to start converting shacks into eco-shelters, which is taking a shack, which is a tin structure, and then using sandbags.
Seen at this building in the Indovlu project.
To build, reinforce the structure in wood, which is environmentally friendly and will create a better living environment.
Tell us about the importance of self-sufficiency and sustainability in the Indovlu project.
Well, sustainability is vital because when you put input into a project, it needs to be able to stand by itself afterwards, and you can't keep on putting input into it. So the project needs to be self-sufficient and stand as a unit and work by itself. Without that, as soon as we pull out from our input, the project will crumble.
While Martin and Reid presented the framework to create an eco-village at the Indovlu project, Emil Nauter and Kishan Chagan worked on a fire retardant in order to prevent the threat of fires in and around the Indovlu project.
This is only municipal tap within 5 kilometers, and so putting the fire out with water is simply not viable. A better option would be to somehow fire retard it.
Emil, can you tell us how you came about this and how you made it?
Well, Kai, we basically used common household chemicals and mixed them to form a solution that very basically stops fire.
How effective is this fire retardant?
Well, the advantages of it are that, first of all, it's a tenth of the price of the manufactured fire retardant that
is possible to buy in supermarkets, yeah, I would imagine.
Exactly. And secondly, it is just incredibly easy to get
hold of. Kishan Chagan, and he is going to explain how the fire retardant is going to be used.
Thanks for your question, Kai. We plan to use this fire retardant in a paint, and that will be put on the interior walls of shacks, as well as the Indovlu project.
As you can see, many of these houses are highly flammable, and you can see with this corridor how they are incredibly close together. They're only about half a meter from wall to wall. So we hope to apply our paint and throw our paint on any sort of wooden surfaces on nearby shacks.
How can the public donate to this venture?
Well, Kai, you can donate to our project at globalgiving.org.
The Bishops Global Issues Network is working alongside the Shasta Foundation, led by Diane Womersley, to assist the development of the Indovlu project as a creche and a community center of Monobisi Park. Situated in Khayelitsha, Cape Town, Monobisi Park is a squatter camp and a home to 18,000 people who have been living for 12 years without running water, sanitation, proper houses, roads, or easy access to healthcare. The community is one of the poorest in Cape Town, with an HIV/AIDS rate of 45%, appalling levels of disease, crime, teenage pregnancies, hunger, and all other effects of poverty. The partnership between the Shasta Foundation, bishops, and the people of Monobisi Park created out of the need to improve the health and well-being, as well as education and living conditions of the poorest of the poor. Though much work is still to be done, it is possible to follow the progress made at the Indovlu project by visiting Global Giving at www.globalgiving.org or the Shasta Foundation at www.shasta.org.za. This is Kainebe for the Bishops Press Team. Umado, umado. Yeah, for Africa. Umado.